Hi, this is Mark with Safe Day Trading. Are you interested in learning how to effectively trade the market for real-time profits? Do you want to supplement your income today or for your retirement? Discover how simple it is to make $300 to $500 a day when you have the Safe Day Trading DOT system. I want to make it easy for you. Go to safedaypodcast.com. Register for the free ebook, Your Fundamental Truth to Making Consistent Money Day Trading. Also, free Safe Day Trading mini course, learn the truths about trading safely and profitably, and free eavesdrop trading session. Listen to us, trade live, and make real money daily. Follow the DOT and make a lot. Remember, it's all free. See you at safedaypodcast.com.
Hey everybody, today is August 8th, 2021. Let's talk about what happened on Friday. I'm sorry, I've been having a cold to deal with. I think I'm much better right now. I'll have occasional cough, and I apologize for that. The Dow hit record numbers on Friday. Boy, it was a really interesting day. The reports came out, and there were the jobs report came out, and was really, really strong, much stronger than we anticipated. So naturally, the Dow took off. Oil dropped down. Now it's at $67. Wow. But it's going to go back up, and especially September driving season for the holidays. So you can anticipate it going back up. And I am. I'm planning on making money at it. Gold dropped $35 on Friday. And most of it happened during our open trading time. It was a, how do you say it? It was a wonderful time. Very profitable for a lot of people that were trading at that point. And $35 is a huge drop, especially when you're in the middle of it. You know, again, if you can get 50 to 60% of the drop, that's my... That's a lot of money right there, and hopefully a lot of you guys that listen to me have made profit. It's going to continue to drop, I think, a little bit more. This jobs report is pretty strong, and I think you'll be able to make some money. Honestly, it was just a great day. Let's look at forward. Well, let's look back for 1 minute, and let's look at the cryptos. Bitcoin dropped a little bit. It was down at 43,000, or it's up. It's down to 43,250. But remember that last week it was at around 35,000, 37,000. So it's gone up. Pretty strength driven, same as the Dow. I'm not sure where that's going, but I am planning on doing a series of interviews with crypto guys. Hopefully you can listen to that and see if it's interesting or not over the next couple of weeks. So let's look forward, okay? Sunday, Monday, not a lot coming for reports. There is the Jolt report that's considered strong. Again, I'm looking at investing.com. But it's later in the day, around 10 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Tuesday, not much there. Thursday, Wednesday, we started to get some serious reports. Core CPI, a lot of CPI reports, real earnings coming out. But they're not that significant for us. Thursday at the 7:30, 8:30 a.m. Central Standard Time, 7:30 Central Standard Time, 8:30 Eastern Time. We got the initial jobless claims, which is strong. PPI, which is producer price index, measures the change of price and goods sold by manufacturers, so that'll be a strong report. at least trade on. And then on Friday, not much there either. A couple of export reports, but nothing serious. So it's going to be a pretty quiet week. Remember, though, we're coming into the middle of August. And because of that, we should be starting to look at more activity on oil, natural gas, the Dow, and gold. A lot more volatility because there'll be more volume traded. So it should start to become a pretty good, strong week for us. I'm at least anticipating it. I expect gold will probably try and climb back up. And the Dow has gone up. Got to remember, though, too, is that the Fed is producing $120 billion of dollars on a weekly basis. So there's a lot of cash sitting out there in the account. Unfortunately, for all of you people that are out shopping for groceries or other stuff, you're probably noticing that the price is increasing for a lot of items, whereas it shouldn't be if the Dow continues to go up. So there's a disconnect there. So think about what's going on and why, because that disconnect is going to hurt us at some point down the road. Now, other than that, I would probably anticipate that this week is going to be a strong volume week. So for me, it really doesn't matter whether it goes up or down. It's just the volume up and down during the day that'll make it pretty happy, at least me happy. So one of the things I want you to do, though, is, and I talked about this a couple of weeks ago, is you've got to be looking at the volume and the movement, and your profit stop has to reflect that, okay? So if the volume is pretty low, then you've got to drop your profit stop. As the volume is pretty high and it moves a lot, you know, raise your profit stop. Raise it from $100 to $150 because, you know, you're looking at movement of $300, $400 per candle. And when that happens, you might as well get a good part of that in terms of trading. If it's, you know, moving like it did on Friday with the $35. I think it actually ended up being a $40 drop. So I in some cases, I actually even took off my profit stop because it was moving. But you also got to remember that it's pretty volatile. And you've got to confirm the direction it's going is the direction you're anticipating, because it could pop up, back up pretty quickly, you know, and you could lose your profits. So it's been a wonderful week. It was pretty slow at the beginning of last week, but by the end of the week, it was strong. And I'm anticipating seeing the next couple of weeks that way. No matter what the administration does, which, well, I don't know. I keep hearing this. They're going to tax you on unrealized returns. I just can't get over thinking that that might possibly be true. I don't know how to measure it. And, you know, you could be looking at swings of $1 million or $2 million from one side to another if you've got a lot of real estate. So we just kind of hold our breath and see what happens. Like I said before at the beginning, I'm going to be looking for some crypto interviews. If anybody out there has a good contact with a crypto expert, please send me a note at mark@safedaytrading.org, and I'd really appreciate it. And I might even give you something for free if it's a good interview, but we'll just have to see what it is. And, man, I'm really looking forward to talking about this with this volatility now. And I understand that the bill that has been passed is going to have some taxable issues for the crypto companies and the crypto investors. So I'd like to give my listeners a heads up because, you know, if you're a progressive and in terms of trading and day trading, you're probably into some part of the cryptos as well. And so it'd be good to kind of get a little update as to where that's going. I really have stepped away from cryptos because I felt I had enough in my hands. But, you know, let's talk about it. Let's find out what they have to think about. What's the second and third quarter, third and fourth quarter issues that might pop up with cryptos. Anyway, if you have some expert, drop me a line and I'll try and contact them. Excuse me a second. I will drop them a line and see if I can set up an interview with your help. Anyway, this is Mark. Talk to you later. Hey,
everybody. I want to mention, too, that we have a YouTube site called Safe Day Trading, which we show you trades that we make with the techniques that we use. You can also send me questions that you might have at mark@safedaytrading.org. Anyway, talk to you later.